In this section, we're going to look at the tracking generator, reflection measurement, and independent source capabilities that are available in Spectrum Analyzer mode. With the tracking generator option installed, we can perform basic scalar network analysis sweeps of two-port devices such as cables, amplifiers, and filters such as this one I have here. There's no phase information being measured in this mode, and hence no vector error correction, so instead we've just performed a simple normalization of the trace to remove any basic flatness errors from the measurement process. So we've turned on the generator by pressing the Source Enable button and setting that to On. We've set the source mode to Tracking. We've normalized the trace by sweeping a straight through adapter first, and it's now performing a simple trace 4 minus trace 1 normalization. We've got the source power set to 0 dBm, and you can see we can see down the skirts of the filter quite happily down to about minus 90 or so dB. We could increase the dynamic range of the measurement, of course, by pressing the bandwidth button and narrowing the resolution bandwidth. But as you know, that will also cause the trace to sweep slower. I'll go back to 10 kHz. And as you'd expect, if I press the marker button, we've got six markers available. There's marker one. Let's turn on another marker. And if I press more, we can display the marker table. This shows us the values of all six markers, their frequency, and their, in this case, insertion loss. And if you also have the reflection measurements option installed, we can easily perform a basic reflection measurement too, using the broadband directional bridge that's built into every FieldFox. We can measure the return loss, or VSWR, of an antenna, a cable, a filter, or an amplifier. Finally, and this is one of the most useful features on the FieldFox, the RF source in the FieldFox Spectrum Analyzer can be used as an independent fixed frequency signal generator. Obviously, it's not as comprehensive as this benchtop signal generator here, but if you're out in the field and quickly need to generate an RF or microwave test signal, or simulate a fixed frequency RF beacon, then it's a lot more convenient than carrying a second instrument out on site. So here we're monitoring a couple of spread spectrum signals using this antenna here that's plugged into the FieldFox's spectrum analyzer input. But if I press the measure key and source, then we can generate a signal out of the FieldFox's second port here with through this second antenna. Currently it's turned off, so let me just press source enable to turn that on, and here you can see the signal. The source mode is set to CW. The source power is adjustable. I've currently got it set to minus 45 dBm, but I can easily adjust that. In fact, I think we can go up to 0 dBm, and the output power is still leveled. Let's drop that back a bit. And we can set the frequency as well. Currently set to 877 MHz, but we can adjust that with the knob, or just enter a numeric value. Hence, we've got an extremely useful amplitude adjustable frequency variable CW signal generator built right into the FieldFox, which can be used at the same time as we're sweeping the spectrum analyzer. And as with all the FieldFox measurements, we can save the results as a PNG or trace file to the internal memory, an SD card or USB memory stick, along with the complete instrument state we've been using for future recall. For further information on the FieldFox, please contact your local representative or visit the website shown below.